Let's turn now to PubMed. We'll be searching the same topic, the effects of diabetes in pregnancy. The first thing that you'll notice is that the interface is much different than CINAHL's. There is only one single search box and no drop-downs to select and or. Despite these differences, we search this database in the same way. The first thing that we want to do is make sure that we're searching PubMed. To do so, look at the top of the screen next to the left of the search box. The box should say PubMed. If PubMed is not listed as the database, use the drop-down menu to select it. Now, type in your search terms. In our case, we will type in diabetes and pregnancy. Notice a few things. First, if we are typing in an and or an or, these terms must be capitalized. Second, there is an autocomplete feature that will try to determine what it is you're typing and give you recommendations. Should you wish to use one of the database's suggestions, click on it, and that item will be sent to the search box. Be aware, however, that the suggested term, diabetes and pregnancy, represents a different search than typing in the terms with the capitalized and. Take a moment to compare the different searches that the database is running. Once again, we'll have to narrow down our results. As we saw with CINAHL, adding additional keywords should help you narrow your search. Let's add the term depression. Go back to the search box and add and depression. Then click the search button. As you can see, we've narrowed down the results. In CINAHL, if you wish to search for a phrase, you used quotation marks. However, quotation marks are not suggested for use in PubMed because they override the search functions of this database. In this example, we are adding the topic of fetal health to our base search. Additionally, it's not recommended or necessary to truncate your search terms in this database because PubMed's savvy functioning automatically looks for variants of the words.